Wouldn't it be super cool to make a card with pockets? And what if I tell you that it's very simple and easy to do and that I have two ways for you how you can go about that? So, well, let's just dive right in.
I'm going to use Juggles envelopes, and these envelopes are in a nice big size. They are sturdy and they can take quite some fluid, so they are really good for mixed media and also to work on with watercolors or fluid inks. The envelopes are going to be the base for my cards with pockets, and I'm going to color them using botanical stains. These are dye inks and the colors have a bit of a vintage feel to them, which is going to be great for this project. I'm spraying some water on my envelope and then I add some ink. And I do that on both envelopes. The bottle comes with a dropper, so it's very easy to apply. You know, don't need a brush or anything to apply it if you don't want to. So I spray some more water and then I spread it with my brush. I'm using a big soft brush, which works really well to spread the color. And then I'm going to add my second color. And this is a brown and it's going to look pretty awful with the colors blending, creating that muddy kind of look that we always try to avoid. That's because there's a bit of orange in brown, and mixing blue and orange when wet will give you a bit of a muddy color. But I promise you this will get better in just a bit. So I spray some more water to dilute the ink a little bit more, and I spread the ink again with my brush. So now I have my color down on both envelopes. I pick up one of the envelopes and put it on the other one to color the other side. Then I pick up that envelope and put it on the other one so that back is also colored. And then I'm blotting. I'm blotting on both sides. So now you can see the color is really subtle. It's a soft tint that will give the envelope a bit of a vintage look. You don't have to blot, you can also use a heat tool, but I'm going for a really subtle and soft color on my envelope base. But you can also use a heat tool or let it dry partially and blot. So this is a really great ink to experiment with, which I will be going to do for sure. I'm going to do the same on the other envelopes because I'm going to make two envelope cards in a different way for a different binding. So I add some color and then I spray my water. And then I add the other color and spray some more water, and this will dilute the ink and it will spread the ink a bit. And I help the ink spreading over my envelope with my brush. And you only need a little bit of ink, so a little bit goes a long way to color your envelope or to color a card. And once the ink is spread over my envelope, I'm going to put the other one on top so I can color the front of the other one. And this will give you a pretty mirror image. Now there's still quite some color left on the front of the envelope, so I'm going to use that to color the back of the envelope also. And I'm doing the same on the other side. And the soft color that you get this way is really cool. And you get a vintage kind of look or a soft colored look without any effort at all. Well, a little bit of effort maybe. I want a little bit more of the purple to the back, so I'm adding a little bit more color. I spray some more water and then I'm going to spread the ink again. I add a little bit of the brown also. Spray some more water and then I'm going to put the other envelope on top to also color that back. So I'm blotting the front and then I'm going to blot the back also. And you can also use a heat tool for a little bit more texture, but I like this soft blended look. And this is what the envelopes look like after drying. They held up really nice with all the fluids that I added, and they are still strong and sturdy. And these are the other envelopes after drying, and I'm going to start with the blue-brown ones to turn them into a card. I add some tape to one flap, right next to the fold. Then I fold the backing piece towards the envelope part. Then I put the flap inside the other envelope. I make sure to check if it folds nicely, and then I remove the backing piece. And now the envelope is in place. Then I'm going to add some more tape to the other flap. I'm going to add the tape on both sides, so on the envelope side and also on the bottom part. And then I remove the backing and I fold the flap in place. And then I have my first envelope card ready. This was a super easy and fast one. And I have some really cool pockets on the inside. For the second card, I want the pockets on the other side. I'm going to fold one of the flaps inside the envelope. And then the other flap, I'm going to cut off a piece, leaving about 3/4 of an inch
in place. Then I add some tape to the part of the flap that's left, and I fold that also to the inside and remove the backing piece. Now I make some score lines on the piece of the flap that's left over, and I make them just right beside each other. And I've added some tape to the flap on both sides of the score lines, and I'm going to line up my envelope on the bottom part to one of the score lines. Once I think it's in place, I'm going to fold the flap to see if it folds nicely, and then I remove the backing piece. And I turn over the envelope and remove the backing piece on the front also. Then I'm going to do the same for the other side. For this one, I'm going to line up my envelope on top of the other one so I know it's in the right place. Then I'm going to add the flap on top, and when I see that it's in place, I remove the backing pieces. And this one folds really nicely and has pockets on the outside. To dress up my envelopes, I'm going to use some gorgeous Stamperia papers. The Around the World paper pad are the leftover bits that I used for the craft along session about patterned paper, and I will link to that in the description box if you like to check that out. There's a replay available. And I have the Passion paper pad, and the Stamperia paper pads come with so many wonderful bits and pieces and details, which make them such a joy to work with and to play around with for your cards or mixed media projects or envelope cards. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use them on my envelope cards. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to cut a bunch of pieces to the right size. So I'm going to measure with the size that I have available on my envelope so it fits on the inside, and then I'm going to cut a bunch of pieces. And it works really easy to cut a bunch of pieces so you have all your pieces together, and this is what I like to do when I have patterned paper. First pick out all the pieces that you want to use, see what would look pretty or what's a good addition to add as a detail. And this is just a really fun part to play around with your papers. Now first I want to get my pieces in place on the inside of the envelope. So I distress the edges of the paper, and now I'm adding the pieces inside my envelope with tape on just one side, because that will be enough. I only distress the outside piece that will be visible, because the rest of the edges of the paper will be hidden inside. Now I'm going to cut a bunch more of the elements that I want on the inside. So I measure with the size I have available on my envelope, and then I cut the piece to size. When I have all the pieces together, I measure and I move them around a little bit. Then I just check if I want some more pieces. And for this kind of design, you can use really small bits and pieces, because they are really great to hide behind bigger elements or to add a little bit of color in small places or a little corner or just peeking out from under another piece of paper. Now all the pieces that I use on my card are distressed, so I'm not going to show you all of that because that will be so boring. So now I'm going to add the pieces in place. For all the paper elements I'm also using, and especially for the big ones, I'm using tape because I like to use tape and that works really well and fast. So now I'm going to add all the pieces in place. And in the craft along session, pattern paper where to start, I will walk you through all the details on how I pick my paper, how I pick all the elements, and often why I pick certain elements and color and why I use them in certain ways. So you can learn a lot more about using patterned paper in the craft along session. So if you are interested, the link is in the description box below for you. So now my inside is done with a lot of detail and some place to write something on. And the pockets are a great place to hide some cards in, to hide some extra details in, maybe some pictures, a gift card, lots of options for you to pick from. So now I'm going to work on the outside, and I'm going to cut some pieces to size again. For the outside again, I have some cards and I have a little sentiment that was on the paper, which I thought would make a nice detail on the cover. So I'm going to cut that to size. And I'm going to use a piece of the lined paper as a mat, and I'm inking the edges so it stands out a little bit more. And for the other side, I'm measuring what piece I want to use, and I cut that to size. And now I have all my pieces together, I'm going to add them to my card.
And layering like this adds so much detail and so much dimension to your page, which adds a lot of interest to the page also. And again, I have some tiny details or little strips, parts and pieces from other pages. And with a project like this, adding the details really adds to the interest of the complete design. And it's just fun to play around with and add some layers on top of each other also with the tiny bits and pieces. This is just fun. And when I add my pieces, you can see the design come together. I've distressed all the edges, so they have a bit of dimension, but they are still flat, which works really well for the inside of the envelope card, because you don't want to add too much dimension there. Adding a little bit of ink every now and then on some pieces to make them stand out more. You can use it without ink. It all depends on the colors of the layers and also if you want the colors to blend or stand out more. I'm squeezing some of the edges of the little card and the sentiment to give it a bit more of the distressed look. I cut off the excess bit that is sticking out and I add some ink to give it a nice finish. And then this is the finished card on the outside and this is the inside where you can hide some things. I think this turned out really cool. For the next card, I already have all the details for the front cover in place. And now I'm going to add all the pieces with some tape. It doesn't really matter where you start with the front cover or with the inside. Just do what you like best or what works for you. I'm tearing a little V-shape so I can hide a little piece behind it. And I use tape for the V-shape, but you can also use glue there. That's also a great option. So I'm going to add a little wood piece to the back, which was also on the left side of the card. And letting colors return on both sides of the card will make the design also come together more. And again, I'm working with some smaller strips, some bigger panels. This is also a great way to use up some scraps, finally, and just make a really cool and layered design. So now I'm going to check for another detail that I can add to the front to give it a bit more interest and to make it more of a front front cover or front of outside or just a front of a card. So I picked this door and the blue of the door also comes back on the other side of the card, so that's a nice detail also. I distressed the edges of the door and now I'm going to pick a few more pieces, little details that I can add behind the door or let them come peek out from under. So I'm fussy cutting these. So I've cut all the pieces and now I'm going to move them around a little bit to see where they look best. And moving them around before you add them is always a great thing. Once they are in place, it's very hard to get them off again. And I decided to add some flowers, so I picked a few from the Passion Collectibles paper pad and I fussy cut them. Now I have all the pieces together and I warmed up the heat gun. For the smaller pieces, I'm going to use some glue to add them in place and I measure with the door so I know exactly where I want to add them. And if it's needed or it looks better that something's upside down, just do it. If it fits the design better, then just put it upside down because you can and it's your design. So I keep on adding the bits and pieces. And now I'm going to add the door in place and it already starts to look really nice. Now I'm going to lay out my flowers and move them around a little bit to see what is the best place to add them. For the flowers, I want to use the glue gun because that will give it a bit more dimension. And though the big flower is not in place yet, I measure with the big flower so I can add the other details where I want them or where they look best. Then I add the big flower in place and then finally the small flower. And when I add the glue to the back of the flowers and bits, then I add a little bit more than needed. And when I add the flower on the card, I don't press it down completely. So there's a little bit of added dimension from the hot glue. So that makes a nice front cover. And then the inside. And you can leave it as is. But of course, I'm going overboard with all my pattern paper because I'm having so much fun. I could have started another envelope maybe. But I want to add some details to the inside too. So I'm going to pick some more pieces. And when I have all my pieces together, I'm going to add them in place. I distressed all the edges again. And using small parts like the lace piece is such a fun detail to use on your card also. I'm putting it on the inside of the envelope, but you can also let it pop out from under a panel or from under a strip. So there are lots of options to use smaller details and smaller pieces. Now just add all the pieces in place. I'm layering again, lots of layers. For the bigger pieces, I'm using the tape again because it works so much easier than glue. For me. But if you prefer glue over tape, then go for glue. You don't have to do what I do. Make sure to measure every now and then so you see that everything is in the right place and it's still visible when you add the next layer. And the papers come with so many details and it's so gorgeous and it's so much fun to work with. I just can't get over how pretty it is and how much fun it is to work with. And with pattern paper it can be hard to get started with it because it's so pretty, but just be brave and put those scissors into it. My final detail will be the big flower. And this makes that the outside details also come back on the inside. And this will help to bring the complete design come together. So this is my finished card with the outside cover, the inside pockets and the back. I had lots of fun. I hope you like this too. So what do you think about cards with pockets? That was super easy, wasn't it? And you can go completely overboard like I did with lots of layers, or you can keep it very simple. That's all up to you. So now you give it a go. And as always, make sure to keep on crafting.